There is a new, record-breaking skyscraper in Europe. The 310-meter-high Varso Tower was recently opened in the Polish capital of Warsaw. The 1,017-foot skyscraper overtook the Commerzbank Tower of Frankfurt, Germany, which stands 850 feet high. This video takes a viewing deck approach as it takes you on tour through the Varso Tower. Please remember to like the video if you love what you see. Also, remember to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to receive notifications when similar, interesting videos drop in. The Varso Tower is a relatively new skyscraper, constructed in the Polish capital of Warsaw. It features an ultra-modern design. Its success story is attributed to H.B. Rivas, the real estate developer behind the construction of the tower. H.B. Rivas has its headquarters in Luxembourg. The company has been active in various European countries, having developed some significant projects in Slovakia, Poland, the United Kingdom, the Czech Republic, Germany, and Hungary. The Varso Tower will offer space for retail, bars, and restaurants besides serving as an office building. Building design and details. The Varso Tower has a total of 53 floors. It has a roof height going 236 meters up in the sky, or just about 774 feet. However, the spire will reach a total of 310 meters up, or 1,017 feet. Its height makes it the tallest building in Poland, surpassing the Palace of Culture and Science Spire, which was previously the tallest building in the country. Apart from holding the record for the tallest building in Poland, the Varso Tower is also the tallest skyscraper in the European Union, surpassing the Commerzbank Tower and Messeturm of Frankfurt. In other words, the Varso Tower will be taller than any other building in France, Spain, Germany, and any other country within the European Union. But this does not include the United Kingdom because of Brexit. But even then, the Varso Tower's spire is exactly 40 centimeters higher than the Shard of Glass in London. It is important to understand that the Varso Tower is part of a larger complex. Although the original plan was to construct a skyscraper that would reach a height of just 130 meters high, the plan was later shelved off when the opportunity to build a much larger complex that would include a much larger skyscraper arose. The final plan was drafted to include two side buildings, Varso 1 and Varso 2, and a gallery on the first four levels interconnecting all towers. It is the same concept that is applied to the three interconnected towers of the Marina Bay Sands Towers of Singapore. However, the Varso Tower is designed to include spaces for shops, bars, and restaurants instead of having a huge lobby. The main Varso Tower is intended to become the centerpiece of the entire project. The two additional towers designated as Varso 1 and Varso 2 will be much shorter. The first tower will have a height of 90 meters or 295 feet, while the second tower will have a height of just 81 meters or 265 feet. The skyscraper will also have an impressive observation deck, which is one of the building's most impressive features. The observation deck will be located on the top floor of the tower. It means that the visitors will have a chance to get amazing views over the city of Warsaw at the height of 236 meters or 774 feet. What an amazing view that is. We believe that the tower, filled with activity and featuring extraordinary rooftop public spaces, will make a strong, positive contribution to this wonderful city. We hope that it will become a hub for local and international business and a symbol for contemporary Poland. Grant Brooker, head of studio and senior executive partner at Foster & Partners, said in a statement, "A word on how the Varso Tower got its spire. The spire is heavily regarded as one of the most significant parts of the tower's design. It tops the skyscraper and adds slenderness to it. Additionally, it is a functional element whose lower part contains lifts that will carry tourists up to the observation deck, while the upper part will be used as an antenna support structure. The spire was made at a Polish plant in Strzelce Opolski and Kedziren Kozel, with individual sections being transported to the construction site. The spire weighs 250 tons and stands 117 meters tall, of which slightly above 80 meters protrudes above the main body of the Varso Tower. And as you can probably imagine, moving the load to the construction site was no mean feat. But the real fun was witnessed on the assembly ground. Assembly work was no child's play, especially owing to the blustery winter weather. But thanks to the professional team of experienced climbers and advanced crane technology, everything went according to plan. Another interesting aspect of the Spire is its maintenance platforms that facilitate maintenance works and safe access to light fixtures at the top of the Varso Tower. The tower's largest platform is over 8 meters in diameter. That is more than a tunnel of the Warsaw Metro. Who will occupy the Varso? The main skyscraper of the Great Varso Complex will be used for renting out office space to various companies. Additionally, it will serve as a tourist attraction. Varso 1 will have a two-level fitness club, a hospital, a four-star NYZ hotel with a total of 330 rooms. Varso 2 is reserved for Cambridge Innovation Center, to which H.B. Rivas, the developer behind the Varso Tower, gave $58 billion in funding and the BGK Bank. The architecture behind the Varso Tower. The design of the Varso Tower has been in the hands of the London-based architectural firm called Foster & Partners. Norman Foster is the founder of the company and hence its name. Foster & Partners company is renowned globally, having accomplished several projects of significant scales around the world. Some of the company's famous accomplishments include the Trafalgar Square renovation, the Gherkin in London, the Index in Dubai, the Hermitage Plaza in Paris, and the famous Wembley Stadium of England's national team. These are just a drop in the ocean of the Foster & Partners projects that have either been completed or still under construction, not to mention the Hermitage Plaza, set to be completed in 2024, and which will eventually become even taller than the Varso Plaza, according to the current estimates. When did construction work start? Construction of the Varso Tower kicked off way back in 2016, when the building permit for the entire project was obtained in December of the same year. The real estate company behind the construction of the Varso Tower bought the land on which the Varso complex now stands in the year 2011. Construction work went on up to the year 2020, when the last floor of the Varso Tower was completed, following the installation of the spire. The tower was topped out on the 20th of February, 2021. In September 2022, the building was officially announced to have been completed. The opening of the observation deck has been planned for the first half of 2023. What is your opinion of the Varso Tower? Is it a destination you would love to visit? Personally, I believe it is, considering its magnificence and ambitious design. Share your thoughts on what you think about this tower in the comments section.